my local village, parish village of Ballinalee, memory the centenary anniversary since the famous Battle of Ballinalee, which was a famous engagement during the War of Independence, when the local IRA column, North Longford column, led by Commandant Sean McKeown, a local hero of the War of Independence from Ballinalee, successfully repelled Crown forces, Black encampments, who had arrived in 11 lorries on the morning of November the 3rd, 1920, with the purpose of burning this village of Ballinalee, as they had previously attempted to burn Granard the previous day. This place is a very solemn place. It's a very historic place. It's Rose Cottage. And Rose Cottage, I can't say it's owned by my family, the Reynolds family, but it was used by Commandant Sean McKeown, who was the commanding officer of the IRA column, during the engagement, during of the Battle of Ballinalee, as the command post for during the battle. And it was here, at Rose Cottage, that Commandant McKeown and four of his colleagues, of his IRA colleagues, opened fire on the lorries, on the trucks, ten of them, which were contained black and tan terrorists that had come to burn and finish the village, but were unsuccessful in that attempt. Although the black and tans and the Crown forces had superior armaments, they had Lewis machine guns, they had one lorry which was parked out the Banner Road with a Vickers machine gun, very powerful. And they failed, despite the superior firepower of the Crown forces. They failed in their objective to lay waste this great proud village. And thanks to the bravery and the courage of Commandant McKeown and the men who fought with him. And the most notable and most famous of them was volunteer Seamus Conroy lobbed two number four Miller grenades at the black and tan lorries after the black and tans had been debussed from the lorries and were on foot, they were met with two hand grenades thrown at them, which caused confusion, and the end result was that there were 15 fatal casualties on the side of Crown forces, and no volunteers thankfully were killed, even though they were down to their last rounds of ammunition. So much so that Commandant McKeown had to ask the command his volunteers to conserve their ammunition as they were down for their last round. And luckily, the Tans didn't realise that they could have had the upper hand, but they had enough and they pulled out and they left this place. And they went down, anyone is familiar with Ballinalee, they went down the Ardna Cliff Road. This road got down past the Catholic Church to the brilliant on the cliff, and they turned left down the Soren Road on their way to Longford. They thought it was safer to go the back road to Longford Town to their barracks in Longford rather than the main road. But IRA volunteers also attacked them on the Soren Road. It proved to be a very treacherous road for them on their way, and to sustain more casualties. In relation to the military tactics of Commandant McKeown, he divided his forces into five, and the primary force was in Rose Cottage, which was the command post commanded by Comyn and McEwan himself. But also he had a detachment of volunteers out the Cullen Kill Road at the Catholic Church at the bridge that crosses the River Camden. He had another detachment at the Protestant Church, St. Emer Cemetery, out the Moat Fire Road. And also, he had another detachment out the Longford Road. And finally, he had a fifth detachment out the Branner Road. And from 9 o'clock the previous night, once they got word from their colleagues in Branner that the Tans were about to embark on attacking Ballinalee, they had scouts ready from 9 p.m. the evening before. So, all in all, Sean McEwan proved himself as an excellent guerrilla military leader and an excellent leader of men, not only politically but militarily as well. He was a great soldier as well as politician. And General McEwan, we'll just go
across
to General McEwan's monument, because I think it's only fitting that we acknowledge the famous blacksmith from Ballinalee, Sean McEwan. Everyone from this parish and this county is rightly proud of. He's a great son of Ballinalee, and the people of this country owe him a tremendous debt. Also, General McEwan was a great friend of General Michael Collins, General Collins is someone who General McEwan owes his life to, more than we as a nation own our freedom to. Fitting monument to General McEwan, and I think I'll just finish this video by just on behalf of the National Party acknowledging General McEwan as the great nationalist leader he was, the great local military leader. He was a proud Ballinalee man, some would say a proud Bunlahi man. I think he was born in Bunlahi. But he was a proud Longford man, proud Irish man, a true nationalist. And we acknowledge this day, 100 years after his successful military engagement here, where, it, as I said at the outset of this, in the beginning of this video, that the Battle of Ballinalee was the only military engagement of its kind where enemy forces, Crown forces, were successfully repelled by, even though they had superior numbers and superior firepower, by the tactical genius of this man, General Sean McEwan, and the brave Irish men that followed. May he rest in peace. Thank you.